Assalamualaikum and good day to all of you. I'm Hazrina. I'm going to present my paper titled The Role of Financial Socialization as the Driver of Financial Literacy, a Pilot Study in Malaysia. All right, so this is my presentation outline. Start with presentation, literature review, research methodology, result and discussion, and last one is conclusion. Okay, for a start, you have to understand that in Malaysia, financial literacy has raised a lot of concern, okay? And a lot of researchers have done research, okay, and they documented various findings, okay? And one of the important finding by AKPK is that they find out that household debt in Malaysia was actually 82% of GDP, and this is much higher as compared to other countries such as Japan, Italy, and United States, okay? And they also find out that that Malaysian has a very high level of debt, okay, and a lot of them has been declared bankrupt, okay, and this is attributed to the low level of financial literacy. Okay. However, financial literacy is still considered as very important and catalyst for financial inclusion. Okay. And the recent pandemic COVID-19 has made it worse, okay, in terms of the financial position of Malaysians, because a lot of residents have lost their job. Okay. And then other than that, due to movement control order, more time is spent with family, right? So it is expected that when they interact with the family members, there will be financial socialization, meaning they acquire indirectly the financial knowledge and experience, because now they stay at home more as compared to in previous period. Okay, so the main aim of this study is to determine the impact, okay, of financial socialization on the financial literacy of Malaysian household. So in terms of literature review, first of all, let's take a look at definition of financial literacy. Basically, there are two components of this definition. First one, that particular person, if he is financially literate, he need to have the knowledge and skill, okay, related to financial decision. And not only that, they need to be able to use that knowledge and skill to make sound financial decision. Okay, then only they are considered as financial literate. Okay, and in relation to the factors that affect financial literacy, basically there are a lot of research that take a look at various aspects. Okay, and most of the research and a lot of them look at from the perspective of financial education. Okay, and from the previous study, we can conclude that financial education can be formal and informal. Okay, formal financial education is from the study in university, school, and so on. Okay, but informal financial education comes from the financial socialization when they interact with the family members, right? And other than that, some of the study look at financial experience, because they say that it is very important to integrate the education with the experience so that they have a strong financial literacy. Okay, strong foundation of financial literacy. However, for this study, we just focus on the financial education, and of course, we would like to look at the impact of financial socialization. Alright, so first of all, let's take a look at the previous literatures on financial education. So for your information, there are various studies that have take a look at the impact of financial education, meaning various field of study on the level of financial literacy. Okay, and in terms of definition, financial education is considered as process to improve people understanding, okay, not in a general concept, but in relation to financial concept and product, okay, and even develop skill through the information they got, right? And previous study have found that this field of study, which is business, economic, finance, and accounting, all this field could result in a better financial literacy of an individual. Okay, why? Because they argue that when they learn, for example, business or economic, finance, and accounting, they are exposed to finance related course, okay, for sure, because the syllabus is of course should be related to the finance related course. Okay, and other than that, this student exposed to financial management concept. Okay, and this could improve their understanding of financial literacy issues. Okay, so this is I would say that the formal education that they can receive during their tertiary education. Other than that, formal education can also be acquired through the financial or finance related course. Okay, for example, there is short course in relation to the managing financial of individual and so on. Okay, so this course from the previous study, they found out that this course also increase the level of financial literacy. Okay, because it familiarize the individual with finance and business knowledge. Okay, so that's why at the end of the day, the financial literacy of that particular individual will improve. Therefore, based on the previous research, we hypothesize that financial education should have substantial influence on individual financial literacy level. Okay. Alright, so next one is financial socialization. In terms of definition, this is actually informal education, meaning the individual informally acquire theoretical knowledge of financial matters, okay, and also learn attitude and behaviors from the people that they socialize, okay, and this will affect their financial behavior. So this is financial socialization is all about, right? And this financial socialization is supported by social learning theory by Hogginson 2007, where this theory said that learning may occur in any setting, okay, where individuals spend the most time, okay, or at young age, okay, and this we can relate to the parents and family and also peers and social media, okay, but in relation due to COVID-19, we expect that more time is spent with family. So in this study, we focus on the most important key social agent, which is parents and family. Okay, and they said that how they acquire this financial knowledge through this financial socialization, because the parents will share their financial experience, discuss the financial aspect, indirectly they teach their children on how to save money, okay, and financially monitor their children, how their children spend their money, okay, and of course, when they discuss the financial decision with the family members. Okay? So this is how this financial socialization can occur in family. Okay, so based on the social learning theory and the previous study, okay, we hypothesize that there is significant impact of financial socialization on individual financial literacy level. Therefore, for the research methodology, we distributed three sections questionnaire, okay, and we managed to get 132 response, okay, because this is considered as pilot study, okay, where we distributed to Malaysian household around August to December 2021, okay, and this is actually a three section questionnaire, where the first section collect information on their demographic, okay, such as age, gender, whether they attend the short course on financial short course and so on, right? And section B asks about the financial literacy level, where we look at the subjective perception of individual on the financial literacy. Okay, and last one is the financial socialization, because we would like to look at the extent in which they socialize financially with their family members, right? So these are the reference of questionnaire that we have used. So basically, this is our conceptual framework. We would like to look at the impact of financial education formally and also informally, which is through financial socialization. And not to forget, we also have a control variable such as age, gender and race. Alright, so now let's take a look at the result. So the first one is the descriptive statistic of this study. So we can see that more female respondent as compared to male, okay, and then a lot or majority of the respondent are Malays, okay, and the average age is 33 years old. Okay, and from the question related to attendance to finance related short course, we can see that majority of them has not attended the finance related short course. So from the descriptive statistic of financial literacy and financial socialization, we can conclude that the financial literacy level of Malaysian is slightly above average. If we convert it into percentage, it is more or less 67%. Okay, and why this is so? Because nowadays it is easily for us to access the information, and we use internet more as compared to like 10 years ago, right? And in relation to the financial socialization, we can see that the mean score is also above average, 14 over 20, okay? And it means that the Malaysian financially socialize with their family members and discuss with their family members in relation to financial matters. So next one, let's take a look at the determinants of financial literacy. But first, let's take a look at the diagnostic test, where as you can see here, the tolerance level and VIF for all the variable here shows that there is no multicollinearity issue. Okay, and then Durbin-Watson of 1.5 shows that there is no autocorrelation issue, and in relation to the instrument, it is reliable because the Cronbach alpha above 0.7. Okay, so next, then only we take a look at the result of the multiple regression. So the first hypothesis is in relation to the impact of financial education on individual financial literacy level, and as we can see, the financial education has a significant positive impact with a significant at 1% level. Okay, therefore the hypothesis one is supported. Okay, and we can say that financial education is very important because it give the required knowledge for that particular person to increase their financial literacy level. Okay, and then for the second hypothesis, where we would like to take a look at the impact of financial socialization on individual financial literacy, the financial socialization also have a significant positive impact, significant at 1% level, right? Therefore, hypothesis two is also supported. Okay, so in terms of discussion, we can say that even though the education is through short financial related course, this can enhance financial literacy level. Therefore, the government should encourage the organization to organize such course and further provide incentive like tax exemption to those organization. Okay, and then the most important thing in this study, we would like to look at the impact of financial socialization. Okay, and based on the result, we can say that the impact of financial socialization on financial literacy level is much larger as compared to financial education. This might be due to the Malaysian spend most of their time at home due to the movement control order in year 2020 and 2021. So this shows that social learning did occur, okay, in Malaysian household during that period, and as a result, it can improve the financial literacy level. So for the conclusion, we can say that financial literacy of Malaysian household is slightly above average, and then Malaysian often talk about the financial matters at home as proved by the descriptive statistic just now. Okay, and though the financial education is a significant contributor, we can say that the role of financial socialization is much greater because the standardized coefficient for financial socialization is much higher. Therefore, we can conclude that financial socialization is a great driver to improve Malaysian household financial literacy level, and authorities should capitalize on this result and encourage a financial socialization so that it can result in improvement on the financial literacy of Malaysian Okay, and especially with current economic outlook, where a lot of changes has happened due to COVID-19, where there is changes in the way people work from work from office to work from home, so they will spend more time with their family members. So hopefully this study can give insight on how financial socialization can help Malaysian in improve their financial literacy level. All right, so with that, that's all for my presentation, and thank you.